Good morning. This is Lynda Cromar from lyndacromar.com. You know, I had a discussion this morning on Facebook, and I thought it might be kind of fun to talk a little bit more about it. You know, I did a video this morning, and then I got thinking that it wasn't really what I wanted to say in my blog today, so I'm doing a new video. And then what I have to say right now about is, how do you use your emotions in the right way when you're building online? There are so many people that go back and forth. Either they're talking like you have to be totally unemotional, and then there's others that are talking like you have to completely use your emotions. Well, I don't think that you can do one or the other completely. I don't think there's a place where you get that way, where you don't have some emotion, because people do respond to emotion. I don't mean that you have to be totally wimpy and I don't know how to put it exactly, but I've seen people that are so just like a wash rag, basically, just to a point where you're just limp with your emotions. But I believe that your emotions can actually make you stronger if you know how to control them in the right way. Now, what on earth could I possibly be talking about? Well, I see people that they love their company, they love their product, and they're totally emotionally immersed in their company. Now, there's nothing wrong with feeling that way, and I know that that is what happens. I even had that experience when I first started out, yes, in Herbalife, and it's nothing bad about any particular company. That just happened to be the one that I first started off with in internet marketing experience just a few years ago, almost five now. And that was that they did lead with the product, and they did get us all emotional about our product. And it was a good thing, because what does it do? It hooks you. It makes you want to stay with it, regardless of whether you're successful or not. But there is another part of that. Do you let your emotions get to the point where it's just about the emotional feelings or whatever result you had, or even somebody else in your family, and it doesn't matter to you if you have success? That's not logical or emotionally sound either. You need to have a balance between the two. And that means that you actually are going to have some success with whatever you choose to do. And it doesn't have anything to do with which company we're talking about. Or you have to feel that you're emotionally comfortable, I guess that's a good word, with the company that you decided to be part of. Let me explain that just a little bit further. In other words, if you are not somebody that cares about using health products and improving their health, then you're not going to be somebody that's actually going to be good at representing something that's health and wellness. Or on the other hand, if you're not somebody that likes statistics and things like that, then you're probably not going to like a financial product. You see what I'm saying here? And it does have to do a little bit with your emotions, but you'd also have to blend a little bit of your logic. And what is your core beliefs? That all has to play a part in what you decide you're going to be part of. So, how do you put that all together? Well, the blog entry will help with that, because I'll give that to you. But there's a difference between being so immersed emotionally that you don't use a little bit of common sense and logic too. You can have both. Yes, you can. And this is Lynda Cromar from lyndacromar.com. And I hope that helps. And let's talk soon.